So because nowadays we have to deal also with a removal, as a removal goes under the same legislation as buildings and new structures. Okay, so let's start. Estonia is a small country with quite a number of rivers, and we have 10 rivers longer than 100 kilometers or equal, and a lot of small ones. Yesterday you saw a picture of this region, and you maybe remember that there were many red rivers where there are many blockages for migrating fish. So this is one of the maps supplied me from the Ministry of was given me from the Ministry of Environment, where you can see some obstacles, some barriers or dams, and this is red ones which we don't have any passages for fish, and there are pretty much of new fish passages as well, you can see. So this era of building fish passages has been already some last 8 or 9 years, and there are really, really many new ones. What are the options? We can have a demolition. We don't like this kaboom stuff, like in some countries is pretty normal, because we are aware of sediments. Then the second is reconstruction, mostly adding some fish passes. I will show you some examples, and definitely Mr. Time, who has ability to demolish, to disintegrate, to rotten the wooden parts, is doing his job. Just slowly, but it's quite a functional guy. Okay, so if we use very large icons, it's really terrible. So there are around 1,000 dams or some other obstacles on the rivers. So it's a kind of problem. This slide is also from the Ministry of Environment, where I can maybe point out some figures that there has been lately 93 investments, where total number of new fish passes have been built lately is 65, and there are also removals. First, I will show you some examples just taken on the same river called Piusa River, which is located on southeast Estonia. And you see that on the same river there has been many, many activities where it seems that the most popular has been a demolition or removal of dams or remains of the dams. And the total investment for this project area has been something like 1 million euros. I have been asked by Pau and other people, so what about the inventory? There has been different inventories done in Estonia. And this is some historical handmade inventory for the same river, where you see that these old mills have been really cascading. And this is a kind of a miracle that at this time of the there were many, lot of fish also. So this is a story I can tell you later, maybe individually why. So you see that this is a really, really like a red berries on the rivers. So some examples about the demolitions. You see here that there are some remains of a dam. So this embankment is not high anymore. This is a before picture. This is about construction. And later, our ethologues and people who are dealing with these rivers and a fish, they prefer a picture like this. A lot of natural stones, granite stones, no concrete. Also, some spillways or bridge spillways which have been already lost their functional idea to be a bridge as well as a spillway. So you see that again, the final result is pretty similar. You see some white water, well aerated, and this one here, here you can see on the left side, you can see also an old mill. And a little bit some impoundment left, but now it looks like this without any building, because it was in a very very bad shape and there was no sense to keep it, and it didn't have any cultural value. Okay, this is another story. This is a quite a nice old mill, and you see a barrier, a dam here, and there were some ideas to use this for making electricity, or but as this river has been also selected as a very very important salmon river for Estonia, so there were made many activities as well. The same place you see on the left, on the right bank, actually the old mill and the bridge, as a bridge spillway, and this is from the downward, and some technical drawings here. So the old original structure, architectural structure, has been restored, and again some technical drawings, and nowadays it looks like the same as the historical one, except that there are no gates, no regulation, and this one here is just to mimic the old structure. So it looks pretty nice and pretty similar to the original one. Okay, there are many small spillways or bridge spillways which nowadays will be replaced kind of large culverts, and at the bottom there are rocks and or rock ramp before it, so that fish can pass. Another one, again, and this is currently under the construction. Okay, the big one. Yesterday, here was a lady, a journalist, maybe she's still here, and she was asking that some ideas where to go, and okay. Please come to Estonia. So on Friday, because then you can still find one large dam, almost intact, but there are people already started to remove it. So first scenes you can shoot on Friday. Be fast. This is a really big project and expensive one. This is a city, Pärnu. And this is one of the largest rivers in Estonia, and this is a Sindi Pais, or Sindi Dam. This is really important because this is almost 15% of Estonian territory. So, and this is the lowest dam. At the upper course, there have been already many activities done. So this dam will be taken down. It will be replaced by rock ramp, And there is some visualization of how it will look like during the low flow season and how it looks like where there is a spring flood or other floods. Okay, risk construction. What has been very popular in Estonia are all these bypasses. Bypasses which are channels filled with rocks, and there are counters counting fish migrating upward and downward, and another sample from the same site. So, and this is a before. So, before that, there was no continuity between this upper part of the watercourse and the lower. Fish could only drop into the sinkhole, but no way back, definitely. Another example and some problematic samples. We have certain structures which has been historically important ones. So this one is the oldest, actually oldest in all Baltics, or in this era Estonia was under the Russian Empire, so it was the first one in this region. So it is a cultural heritage, and it's not so it's prohibited to take it down, so there should be some other measures taken to please both fish and historians. So some examples. Okay, I don't have a time to explain this, but the problem is with this historical one that this is at the mouth of the river. So if this can be resolved, then fish can find their way up, and there are dams which will be taken down later. Okay, this is the only one fish lift which is not functioning because there are no fish to lift, because this is at the upper course, so so yes, some peculiarities. And one lake, this is artificial lake, which is, if there is somebody from Norway Sweden, you can recognize this is a type of fjord or very nice, but definitely there are many, many people who want to take this dam down and restore the original river. And there are some technical alternatives we are discussing. These are not allowed in Estonia, but people from Austria should recognize that this is this kind of double structure with two Archimedes screws. One is screwing electricity, another one is screwing fish upward. So this was taken from Austria, very, very popular. Every year there will be, I think, new and several stations like this. Okay, Mr. Dime. Mr. Dime is doing slowly, but it is degrading the concrete, rottening the wood. And this is a picture actually taken. Yes, thank you. This is almost last of my slides. So it's gone. No obstacles practically without any human activities, but it takes time. And this is the last one. Here in this room are many engineers, hydraulic engineers, with the same background as me. So I gathered most of these pictures from them. Only the first guy up here is not present in this event, so it seems that for Estonian near future, this issue about removal dams is a really important one. Thank you.